control of this effective government. So our Prime Minister can rest assured of an effective and smooth 5 years. And it was the home of Oliver Cromwell, who defeated the Scots at Dunbar, incorporated Scotland into the protectorate, and transported the Scots as slaves to the colonies.
Is that it's full of Scots?
Good morning. The people of Scotland have spoken, and it is a clear result. They have kept our country of four nations together. And like millions of other people, I am delighted. As I said during the campaign, it would have broken my heart to see our United Kingdom come to an end. And I know that that sentiment was shared by people not just across our country, but also around the world, because of what we've achieved together in the past and what we can do together in the future. So now it is time for our United Kingdom to come together and to move forward. A vital part of that will be a balanced settlement, fair to people in Scotland, and importantly, to everyone in England, Wales and Northern Ireland as well. Let us remember first why we had this debate, and why it was right to do so. The Scottish National Party was elected in Scotland in 2011, and promised a referendum on independence. We could have tried to block that, we could have tried to put it off. Just as with other big issues, it is right to take, and not to duck, the big decision. I am a passionate believer in our United Kingdom, and I wanted more than anything for our United Kingdom to stay together. But I'm also a Democrat, and it was right that we respected the SNP's majority in Holyrood and gave the Scottish people their right to have their say. Let us also remember why it was right to ask the definitive question, yes or no. Because now the debate has been settled for a generation, or as Alex Salmond said, perhaps for a lifetime. So there can be no disputes, no reruns. We have heard the set will of the Scottish people. Scotland voted for a stronger Scottish Parliament backed by the strength and security of the United Kingdom. And I want to congratulate the No campaign for that, for showing people that our nations really are better together. I also want to pay tribute to Yes Scotland for a well-fought campaign, and to say to all those who did vote for independence, we hear you. We now have a chance, a great opportunity, to change the way the British people are governed and change it for the better. Political leaders on all sides of the debate now bear a heavy responsibility to come together and work constructively to advance the interests of people in Scotland, as well as those in England, Wales and Northern Ireland, for each and every citizen of our United Kingdom. For those in Scotland sceptical of the constitutional promises that were made, let me say this. We have delivered on devolution under this government, and we will do so again in the next Parliament. The three pro-union parties have made commitments, clear commitments on further powers for the Scottish Parliament. We will ensure that those commitments are honoured in full. And I can announce today that Lord Smith of Kelvin, who so successfully led Glasgow's Commonwealth Games, has agreed to oversee the process to take forward these devolution commitments with powers over tax, spending and welfare, all agreed by November, and draft legislation published by January. Just as the people of Scotland will have more power over their affairs, so it follows that the people of England, Wales and Northern Ireland must have a bigger say over theirs. The rights of these voters need to be respected, preserved and enhanced. It is absolutely right that a new and fair settlement for Scotland should be accompanied by a new and fair settlement that applies to all parts of our United Kingdom.
Landslides do not on the whole produce effective government. So our Prime Minister can rest assured of an effective and smooth 5 years. And it was the home of Oliver Cromwell, who defeated the Scots at Dunbar, incorporated Scotland into his protectorate, and transported the Scots as slaves to the colonies. Now, there's an answer to the West Lothian question.
Is it a sort of Scots? Stupid, 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 st